guys know what that's called?
Dentist.
A dentist.
That's a dentist. Right. I went to the dentist before.
That's good. Oh, good.
I hope you've all been to the dentist.
We do. You had to.
Right? Right? Kindergarten.
To get into kindergarten, you had to sign that paper.
Yeah. And hey, Dr. Eric's office is in Downers Grove. Yeah. It's just a couple miles from here. He does a lot of work in the community. He works with the Chicago Bandits, the women's softball team, and all kinds of different organizations. He's won a lot of awards. I saw you were top dentist in 2015. And, well, he's our kids' favorite dentist. They like to go.
Them are stories. This one's kind of a song, I suppose. But I think we'll go with the story ones. I think we've got about 10, 15 minutes or so to take care of it, and we'll have some socializing time. At the end, I gave your teacher some fun sticker books. We do a fun thing twice a year called Tooth Fairy Day. It's free to the public. You don't have to become a patient or be a patient. Basically, it's a great way to meet the dentist, but also you get to meet the Tooth Fairy. She comes in, and you get to go for a ride in the chair, and you get to see what a dentist's office looks like. And then you get to go and you get to meet the Tooth Fairy. She's got fun balloons and things like that. So that's left. Those are some of our books that we give out on Tooth Fairy Day. That's just a fun thing. Yes?
I have a loose tooth.
You do?
Yeah, I have.
I imagine a bunch of you probably got loose teeth.
Has loose teeth.
Yes. That's all of them? That might be trouble.
Might
be some tiny dentures. All right, well, yes, I'm sorry, yes. You lost it too. I can see it from here.
Yeah.
It's easy to use a straw then. You can just stick it right there. Yes, Miss Claire.
Maybe you can imagine.
You did. That's perfect. Good. Well, I'll tell you what. You lost an imaginary tooth?
No. Maybe you can put an imaginary tooth in there.
Oh, I'll be good. I'll there. Done. Let's read this one. The Night Before the Tooth Fairy, right? This is by Natasha Wing, illustrated by Johansson Newman. All right, we'll see if I can read this like a teacher. The Night Before the Tooth Fairy. 'Twas the night before the Tooth Fairy would come to take my tooth. I'd been so excited ever since it got loose. My bottom tooth was dangling and twisting about. Tonight was the night, it just had to come out. I wiggled it and waggled it for such a long while my baby brother flashed me his funny toothless smile. Mom handed me an apple. She said, "Here, take a bite." No, because if I swallow it, guess who won't come tonight?
Tooth Fairy.
Tooth Fairy, right. Dad said, "Let's yank it out with a doorknob and string." "No way, no how," I told him. "You're not going to do a thing." Then my brother grabbed our kitten, which scared our cockapoo, who knocked me right over, and out my tooth flew. My brother looked around the floor on his hands and knees. When he found it, picture time, we smiled and I yelled, "Cheese." Then I ran to the mirror. And what did I see? A cool gap in my smile.
What?
Where a tooth used to be. I could stick a straw through it and sip up my drink. See, I didn't make that up. That's real. Or pretend I'm a fountain and spray water in the sink. All righty, said Mom. Time to climb into bed. Or the Tooth Fairy may visit some other house instead. My tooth was under my pillow with care in hope that the Tooth Fairy soon would be there. And look, there's a sign. What's the sign say? Tooth Fairy, look under my pillow. That's where she usually looks. I hopped in and nestled all snug in my bed while visions of fairyland danced in my head. When what to my wondering eye should appear but a twinkling glow? The Tooth Fairy was here. There she is. Her wand, how it glittered, her dimples, how merry, her wings were so sparkly, so light, and so airy. She reached under my pillow, I pretended to be sleeping, and slipped my tooth in a pouch where it stayed for safekeeping. I kept one eye open as she fluttered around, then poof! She was gone without making a sound. I dug under my pillow and found something funny. All right, the Tooth Fairy left me some money.
And that's a rhyme.
It is a good rhyme. That's a whole. That's a dollar.
I got a dollar.
Yeah.
I got two.
You got two?
Yeah.
That's good. You got three? That's good.
I got $5 bills.
Whoa! I'm coming over to your house. What's that? Very nice.
I'll go
$1 on those. Oh, good. My mistake. Let's finish it up. We've digressed. We've derailed here. Let's go back. All right, where were we? We were talking about, money. All right. Look what I got, I yelled. Oops, sorry. With a whoop and a holler, the tooth fairy gave me a spanking new dollar. That woke up my brother, who started to cry. When Dad picked him up, we could see why. Now my brother and I both have a new grin. First, my first tooth came out. His first tooth came in.
What?
How about that? Wow. Yay. You do?
Bravo.
I bet you all have teeth coming in.
Bravo.
Bravo, thank you.